Remember when your abuelita, your grandmother used to make jam, jalea de mango y jalea de guayaba and jalea de fresa? And so we would drive up and leave it on the door, ring the bell, and then run back to the car and then wave and, you know, throw kisses. And who around us is offering the services and the goods that we need? Because again, we really need that human connection. Every Friday, we started happy hour with some friends, and we started every Friday, but we eventually had to stop because it was just too lit. Bienvenida! Welcome! This is my very first YouTube video. My name's Elena, and this channel is called Latina Literati, for Latinas and Latina friendly, which is basically the whole world. Today's video is about caring for others, caring for yourself and caring for others. Coming together, love in the time of COVID. Today we're gonna talk about three concepts. The first concept is the journey we've taken together over this past year. We've all been through a lot, and as Latinas and Latina friendly, I wanna dedicate this first video to all the women and everything we've been through in this past year, because we really have taken the emotional toll of this year, making sure that everyone around us is well. And how did we adapt? Well, we adapted through using screens. I'm sure that you were on video calls more than you've ever been. I'm sure that you were trying to find ways to connect with your family and friends. So one of the ways that we all tried to adapt was through social distancing. So maybe meeting up at a park or at a beach, or maybe even a garden or a deck, or even in front of the garage, because we all need that human connection. Also, drive-by celebrations. My two children graduated and all they got was a mock, and they got a mock graduation and a lot of congratulations virtually, but we weren't able to celebrate in any way. And I'm sure that there were many, many of you that had momentous occasions that we simply couldn't celebrate in the traditional ways. And so the drive-bys were a way of acknowledging and celebrating these occasions without actually being in contact with each other. Completely different than what we've ever had to do before. What have we learned? What have we distilled from this past year? What we've learned is that we value those that we care about and those that care about us. And so what's really come through is that people matter, and the people in your life matter even more. And so how do you keep them well? You begin by taking care of yourself. You have to begin first by ensuring that you're well, that you're getting enough sleep, that you're eating well. And that means boosting your own immunity, because the first defense for anything is your own immune system. And so you need to make sure that you're eating good foods, and that's preferably locally produced plant-based foods. So everything that your immune system needs, you can get from foods, but you should also try and speak to your healthcare provider about supplements, because those are really important as well. I'm not a health professional, but I'm a bibliophile, which means I read a lot about all sorts of things, especially the immune system in this past year and how we can bolster it to keep us safe and be able to keep everyone around us safe. So what this pandemic has really unmasked are the inequalities in our society. So the greatest job loss for women since women entered the workforce has been this pandemic in the past year, because if there's no childcare and children need to be attended to, it's mostly women who are taking care of that. We're really taking the brunt of the economic issues of the pandemic in this past year. We also have the lines of cars for people who needed help putting food on the table. So the food insecurity is real. Also, 5 million of our neighbors are in real peril of losing their homes. So housing insecurity is also real. And so how do we help each other? How do we lift each other up? One of the things that we did was we started, every Friday, we started happy hour with some friends. And we started every Friday, but we eventually had to stop because it was just too lit. And we ended up having issues. We ended up with home front consequences. So we tapered off the happy hours, but started with other types of social gatherings at a distance. One of the the ideas that my sister had was we would bake bread. And so we did that for probably several months, once a week, usually on Sundays. We would start on one side of the bay and literally circle all around the bay, dropping off lemon loaf or cinnamon bread or banana bread or pumpkin bread or carrot cake. And so we would drive up and leave it on the door, ring the bell, and then run back to the car and then wave and, you know, throw kisses. And it was wonderful. And I think we enjoyed that more than the family and friends that received the bread, because it was so wonderful to connect and to see everyone, even if it was from afar through a pane of glass. And so these are just ways that we try to keep human connection during the pandemic. And I'm sure all of you have your own stories. I would love to hear what you did to keep connection. So please share with us in the comments below how you kept connection during the pandemic. So as we see a light at the end of the tunnel, what we need to do is take away all of the good things that we learned during this year of trials and tribulations, and ensure that we continue to do the things that we learned to do, which was to take care of each other and really take into consideration that every day, every purchase you make is a decision as to the values that you want to promote. And so do you want to support your community, your local service providers and good and providers of goods? And I think the answer is yes. And so we really need to focus on doing that. The farm to table boxes. So many farms in areas will offer you a box of really fresh fruits and vegetables directly from the farm, and you're helping local farmers and you're getting really fresh produce. So that's a great option as well. And it also means that then you don't have to necessarily go to the store. What you need comes to you, and you can usually personalize the boxes. So that's great too. Downstairs, down below, we have some book recommendations for you. And so you can choose one or two or all of the books. And I'm always going to do books in Spanish and books in English. So if you're Spanish challenged, you can always learn a bit because I feel like everyone should know Spanish. So what we are going to do is every week we'll have a couple of books in both Spanish and in English for you to consider reading. And of course, if you can get them at your local library, that's important. And if you decide to purchase them, I would suggest that you recommend that you first look at who your independent booksellers are in your community. Because again, we want to help the booksellers in our community. We want to uplift those who are around us and who provide the goods and services that we need. And so, for example, our local bookseller's down just a few blocks away, and on Friday nights, he offers jazz. He's been doing it virtually during the pandemic. How fun is that? You just hook in and he asks you to donate whatever for the musicians. But you want to support those in your community that are offering the goods and services that you want. If perchance you live in a community that doesn't have an independent bookseller, then my recommendation is sites like Better World Books. And Better World Books, what they do is every book that you purchase, they then contribute books to communities that need literacy programs and materials. So how amazing is that? With every purchase of a book, then you can increase the impact of that purchase to communities where books are needed. This is not affiliated, not sponsored. I'm in no way connected to any of the products and services that I'm recommending. I've just used them and I've enjoyed them. And so also, let's, as women have been the most impacted, let's try and lift up our hermanas, the women around us who are offering goods and services that we use. And so downstairs, down below, I am including a couple of women-owned skincare and housewares for you to consider supporting. And I would invite you to look around in your community for women that are producing products that you need. You remember when your abuelita, your grandmother used to make jam, jalea de mango y jalea de guayaba and jalea de fresa? So these women's products are like that, but for your skin. So delicious. You can just feel the love with which they're made. It's really wonderful. And so I would invite you to support them and let me know. comment, please, if you know of other women entrepreneurs that we should support, because it would be wonderful to also hear what you have in your communities in terms of women that are making the goods and products, that are offering the goods and services that we can all use. So there'll be links in the description downstairs below for these women-owned companies that make these wonderful products. So I invite you to support them, to take a look at them, and to share in the comments that you may leave what other products you recommend that it may be women-owned. So thank you so much. Thank you to my technical team, Mija, te adoro. Thank you to my hermana, también te adoro. And I wish you health and happiness y siempre mucho amor. So stay tuned for our next video. Okay, we're good? It's a wrap. See, what I wanted to say at first and I forgot is showtime.